Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of all ages. Welcome to this rooftop edition of the RB Bandwagon. Here I am coming to you live from the top of my 2005 Chevy Express box van that I converted from an old electrical work van and turned it into my painting office on wheels. I take it around and we paint up windows, murals, signs, and more. And that's what I've been doing. If you haven't watched my channel, you can look back and see some of that. However, today's a little bit different. We're just gonna give you the updates of what's really going on here at the RV Bandwagon Central. Today is one of our last days of traveling around Florida. Can you believe it? It's already that time. No, we're not leaving. We're here. But we have an annual site and we're getting ready to move on to it here in the next few days. And I'll show you that when it happens. But we're kind of looking forward to that and kind of not, depending on how you look at things. We've been traveling for quite a while and really have got used to it. It's very inexpensive to do that. However, we want to upgrade our lifestyle a little bit in the fact that we have a business that's established and that Kristy can get her own kind of work going if she decides to do that. And have a place to hang out, meet new friends, and play some music, all that kind of stuff. And that costs a little bit more to do that if you're going to live out here on an annual site level. And that's what we've decided to do. So we have to make sure that all of our ducks are in a row and that doing the annual site thing is going to be the right thing. Right now we're here at this park called Clarebrook, and there is a lot of park models for sale here. All of them are pretty used, but I think a few of them have been reconditioned. The price is a little bit high for them. They're not new, but some of them are going for kind of new prices because they're already set up. Not what I'm looking for so much. If I'm going to get a new one, I want it to be a kind of a custom model, one that has upstairs loft area, that kind of thing. Metal roofs. There's various things that I'm looking for. I haven't ran across it yet for the right price. Still looking. Yeah, this park has a lot of people. There's over 1,000 sites, and I think probably 125% of them are used at this point. Everything's busy out here in Florida. All the parks are busy. Everything's booked up. And if you haven't got a reservation several months in advance, you probably aren't going to get one. So that's something to keep in mind this time of year if you're here in Florida. We're on our way to springtime already. It's hard to believe it feels like it out here today. That's for sure. We've had some cool weather. But today we're running probably about 77 degrees, 78, I'm guessing at this point. Sitting up on the roof, enjoying the rays. You gotta look that. Check this out. Yeah, what have I been doing? Working on murals. I'm in the process right now of working on a mural as we speak. Well, actually I've been working on it in drawing form, trying to get a sketch worked up that is appropriate and doable and that the customer likes. So I've been working on that a little bit. But outside of that, trying to get some time to get out to the Disney parks, to Universal Studios, maybe SeaWorld, and some of the other theme park areas out here and check them out, make a video, and see what's really going on at the theme parks. I've been watching some videos of other vloggers out there having a good time, seeing what's going on, checking the prices, and they're not cheap. But I still want to go. I've been working like a banshee, and it's time to take a little break and have some fun. So that's what I'm going to be doing. So you may be asking, well, Scott, what's keeping you out in Florida? Well, I got to say, it's mostly the work and definitely the weather. And my daughter's out here, and I'm trying to reconnect with her, but she's really busy. She travels a lot, and she has my granddaughter, who is her sidekick and travels with her. And so she stays awfully busy, but I know they're going to be back very soon and we're going to meet up. And if you are watching this video, Amanda, yeah, let's do that soon. I've been doing work to the van and I've been doing work to the RV, trying to get them up to par again because we've been using them so much. I've been playing some music, that's right. I've been playing my drums, which I kind of got away from for several years because of how sick I got, and it was hard for me to play the drums. Still is a little bit. Getting better at it each and every day that I practice, so I'm going to play some of that for you right now. Check this out. I mentioned Clarebrook, the park we're staying at, is on a golf course. It's a really big golf course. Well, one of our thousand trails happens to be at a golf course. But, you know, I'm not the biggest golf fan, that's for sure. I don't know how they call it a sport. It's kind of like bowling, you know. There's really not much sport to it. It's mostly a lot of drinking and driving around your golf cart drunk. I mean, at least here at this park and other parks I've been to, a lot of people like to drive drunk on golf carts. It's kind of a thing out here. Rarely have I ever seen more than maybe 10 people at one time in any section of a golf course. I don't know. Some people find it very relaxing and enjoyable, even competitive, I guess. I mean, there are many golf courses which do have kind of moving objects and, you know, different types of scenarios that you have to get through that make it a little more competitive than just kicking a ball around on the green. That's what I think. And they're a lot smaller. They don't take up all that massive space. But what do I know? This park is primarily, you know, retired folks that come here that I can tell. I've seen a few younger people, not that I'm young at all, but at least in my age group, young. Here, you're up in the 70s. Give or take, late 60s, 70s, and 80s, probably. Some of them aren't very happy about the life they've had. But there are a few that are drunk, so you can talk to those guys. And then out here, especially, you got those guys who wake up and live and breathe golf. That's what they do. They have golf carts. Golf carts is a huge thing out here. It's kind of like a status symbol. They charge way too much for them. I'm thinking of going back to Oregon and buying about 10 of them and bringing them out here and doubling the price, because that's what people are paying for golf carts out here. Kind of blows me away. You know, you can pay $15,000 for a golf cart out here. It's true. It's crazy, but true. And what about my dog, Ryder? Well, Ryder's awesome. The best dog I ever had. And as you can see, he's loving life. He loves Florida. He loves the birds out here. He loves all the different wildlife. And the squirrels. He's big time into the squirrels out here. He's never been so into squirrels as he is out here in Florida, because there are a lot of different variations of the squirrels and a lot of them. So he is good with all of that. You know, he's getting a little bit older. I think he's 6 years old now. Just been the best dog ever. And he's getting more mellow around all the other dogs, but he still likes to protect his property. Still trying to ride the e-bikes whenever we can. Been way busier than needed to actually be able to ride e-bikes. But I have been trying to get them out and at least ride around the parks and the general areas. So yeah, that's awesome to do. It really gets you out there breathing a little bit deeper and enjoying the sunshine, getting those vitamin D rays coming on in. You know what I'm talking about. You might have remembered back in last July when I had this stormtrooper I called Troopy, and I built him out there when we were selling fireworks in Effingham, and I ended up selling him out in Effingham. Well, since the days of Effingham, I've completely done a complete whole new trooper freestanding prop, and he's almost done. I would say 98% done. A few little details to do to finish him up, but he's going on the market here pretty soon. I kind of like making these things and selling them every chance I get. I also have been working on a bike I found that I'm gonna go ahead and fix up and resell. Another thing I love to do is work on bikes. You know, I've always loved bikes, and this is kind of a neat one. It's a 26 inch fat tire mountain bike, and I want to make it an e-bike. I got a battery for it, so I'm going to see if I can do that. It might be an upcoming project I show you guys. So I hope you've enjoyed this video from the RV Bandwagon. Remember, I've got more coming at you always, because we're in one of the places that has the most things going on any given day. So we try to get out there and check them out for you and take you guys along, and then put them on video so you can watch them over and over and over again. That's right. And if you haven't already, make sure you subscribe, because I've got new stuff coming out all the time. Make sure you give us a like, because it's helping us get the channel a little more well known on the YouTube analytics. That's an awesome thing. And just let people know about us by sharing the video. Say, hey, look at this goofy guy, man. He built a weird van out of an old junk van. Something like that. Just pass it along. Tell people about the RV Bandwagon. Thank you, Lord, and thank you, viewers. I really appreciate you guys for watching and staying tuned until the end here. I got more coming at you right about now. Check this out.